Today we are going to make this into this all can take no filler. Well, except this.
Hello there.
Here we're in After Effects. Disclaimer: I am assuming you know how to use After Effects. This tutorial is not going to teach you how to use After Effects, so go into comp settings, 320, that's the original size of the PNG sequence from Disco Diffusion, and name it Dancer, drag in the video file, right click transform, fit to comp. It's a bit too big, so let's match it up to the PNG sequence. Shrink the comp, bring in the sequence. You notice because we cut out half the frames when we rendered it in Disco Diffusion. If you don't see stretch on there, right click columns, and you are at it. You can also hold Alt or Option and just pull it out. So pull match the film, maybe. Give a little more just to give it a little flavor offset. I'm at 251.5 and then double click. That's the frame blending, so it just makes it look a little cleaner. See how? It moves the flow better. From the comp, right click on that. So let's see, let's rename this layer because we always label all layers. That's Paul Hogan's son, Ben Marriott. If you are not following him, you need to follow him. He is great. So now let's add a linear color key. Boom, take out the white. Let's match softness. Bring it to, let's say, 62. No, 2. Let's do 2. That's the PNG sequence. It should match up. But now we're going to make it into a matte, so it'll block everything. Off our matte. Boom. Now you get the transparency. And it still looks, whatever, not so great. So going into the video, let's play around with the position and scale a little bit, just to give it a little bit more of an offset. But old style weirdness. See how it has a little more flavor now? Kind of like an outline stroke almost. I don't know. I like it. So shut up. Here we go. Bring in another video layer. Fit it to the comp. Name it. Always label our layers. Let's see now. Boom. Transform. Fit to the comp. Should be identical in size. Let's change the mode to lighten. After you frame blend. Lighten. There you are. And now I see it just gives it a, you can kind of see the video a little more, seems less abstract. Do another color key. Same thing, but this time we're going to play with the tolerance. Let's go 38. That's good, but it's a little too crunchy. You know, like Captain Crunch. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Who's got time for that?
So let's do a little matte choker. Everyone likes to choke a matte out. And let's go ahead and bring this all the way down. You see what it does here? Just cleans it up a bit. You know, boom. See the difference? Do you see that? You better see it, dance dance. I think that looks all right. Let's go there, and then add an adjustment layer. Name the layer posterize time. This will give it more of the classic animation look. 12 frames per second works. You find all the effects here, but it's just a giant mess. I use Vidhihu Cowpilot's console. I mean, it's amazing. I'll post a link in the description. I don't know how anyone can use After Effects without it, and it's free. Now we're going to add a solid layer to be used as a background. I like to use a filler effect too, just because the quicker control, you don't have to keep going into layer solid settings if you ever want to change the color. Then on top of that, we'll put a hue saturation, colorize and go 100 and then 2020. You're going to tick on that. That would be option or alt click on the stopwatch. Either you could do a wiggle, 5,500, which kind of I feel looks a little better. Or you could just make it easy and put a time say 1,000. And you could readjust this depending on how many seizures you want to invoke on people. Just flicker the colors. You know, endlessly on and on and on. Funky, I don't know. For maybe an NFT art piece. Or something if you're in search of a nice heap of that. Space mode and a turbulent displace. This is another technique I learned from Ben Marriott, and it is a really great technique. Change the amount to 4, offset it a little bit. I always put it to high.
It's like my pops used to always say, it's better to be high than low.
Do the same thing with another expression. I do time x3 and that just give a little jiggle, so it looks kind of more hand drawn. You know, looks more classic animation-ish style. You can notice it a bit more when you're eating pasta. Awesome. I duplicated it by hitting Ctrl D. And then we'll change the amount to 30. Size to 2. Actually is to high. We're going to have that same expression as before. This gives it more like a grungy hand-drawn edge look. Sometimes it does not work. So a lot of times I will not use it, but for this instance it works. Then I'm going to copy the first turbulent displace. Using Ctrl C, copy dat my brew from another SU, then paste it on the matte layer. So it kind of has its own little thing you could play around the expression, make it more offset if you want, but I'm not going to do that right now. These are all bonus effects. I mean, you could already be done with this and be the new Crypto King. You got 500 ether for this masterpiece. You are living on an island somewhere. Staten Island, Long Island. I mean, why dream small? We can add an echo effect. Intensity 0.94, the decay leave alone. What do you think for echo 3 echo? I do not know. I did negative 0.00066 in echo time. This is all optional. I mean, I like it, but I feel there's not too much control over it. It's just a cool little after effect. See what I did there? I am hilarious Tommy Hiddleston, better known as Loki the Trickster. Now this trick I didn't find out for years in After Effect. Go into the compositing options, hit the E key, go to your effect and open it up. You can kind of use it instead of using the effect CC composite, and lighten individual effects, instead of having to play around with all this madness and you know get the look you like. Everybody has a different opinion on what they like. That's art. It's all a bit subjective. Now if you really want to get crazy, remember this is all on a transparent background. Render it out as a movie offer, then you can put it on any footage. Or you could just turn around and slap in your own footage. I just happen to have some rabbits. Rabbits George, I just aged myself right there. But you know, for the scale to about 14.8, because I'm just a master mathematician. Position, move it so we can see the little bugger. We're going to name him Mr. Brimley, because he's got diabetes and looking to do a little dance. Now I am going to show you how to upscale, with no plugins, all directly in After Effects. I normally use Topaz Film Enhancer. I mean, it is not free, but has saved me so much time. You can work in smaller proxy sizes than upscale later, and 90% of the time it is almost flawless. But this way you could do it for free in After Effects. I pre-comped everything and using the effect detail preserving upscale. It works good, but it's not the best, but definitely will do the job in a pinch, especially for stuff like this that is artistic and abstract. Maybe put an unsharp mask effect on it just to clean it up. Set amount to 66, a little clean up, and that's it. Now go get rich on OpenSea or whatever those NFT sites are. Send me money or just let me know what you think in the comments. Laughing. I would really like to see what you do with this. Tag me on Instagram, TikTok, etc. I'd love to see what you are doing with these techniques when you use them, and if they work for you. Also, please ask me any questions in the comments. I've discovered so many things over the years and I'm just trying to give back to the artistic community. I wish I had someone showing me these techniques back in the day. So no, I want to pass it on now for free. I'm not doing this to become a YouTube rock star or make money or whatever. I'm just doing it to spread the creativity. So I am hoping you learned something today and also enjoyed. Hope to see you back here soon, I reckon. This is Sir Tommy Hiddleston, signing off my brews and sues.